G'day everyone, my name is Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. Welcome to this video, which is in the Series 4 Free Math Worksheets. And this week we're looking at dividing by 10 and dividing by 5. Now neither of these are terribly difficult. Let's start again with our friends the 10 frames. Here we have 4 lots of 10. So we will have taught our students previously this sort of thing. 4 tens is the same as 4 multiplied by tens. We give it the name 40. We can see 4 keeps coming up in the name of it and how we write it down and so on. So if we were to say how many tens equal 40, of course the answer will be 4, and that's really simple. If the students were in doubt about that, it wouldn't take much practice for them to get that, and looking at the 10 frames, that's certainly pretty obvious. Let's move on to the slightly more difficult question, which is dividing by 5. 40 divided by 5 equals, so we could say to our students, how many 5s can you see? Where can you see 5s? So students should be able to see quite easily there are 5 in this column. There's another 5 there, another 5, another 5, and so on. And so I suspect what they might do first off is to count the number of 5s and go, well, look, there's 8, that must be the answer. But we can draw our students' attention to the fact that each group of 10 is made up of 2 5s, and every 10 has 2 5s. So if we know the number of 10s, what would we get if we doubled it? So if we take that number and double it, look what we get. We get 8. And of course that works for any multiple of 10. So we could go further than this. Say, here's an example. 130 divided by 5, what would the answer be? Well, it's going to be double 13 or 26. So it works for any multiple of 10. All right, so far so good. What if we're not doing a multiple of 10? So if I take 5 of these away, so we now have 35 divided by 5. Could we do the same thing? Well, it turns out, yes, we can. Because we could say, how many 10s do we have? We've got 3 10s here. How much of a 10 is the 5 on the... Well, it's half a 10. So what if we took 3.5 and doubled that? What will we get? Well, double 3 is 6, double a half is 1, so of course double 3.5 is 7. So the strategy works whether it's a number ending in 0 or a number ending in 5. None of that's too difficult. On the worksheets, you'll see a range of questions. There are some related multiplying by 5 number facts to start with. Then we have a set of dividing by 10, a large set of dividing by 5, and in the top right-hand corner, multiplying by 5th and multiplying by 10th. Now, we've looked at multiplying by fractions in an earlier video. Your students will need to get used to the fact that a fifth of something is the same as dividing it by 5, and so it's just another notation for the same operation of dividing by 5. Okay, that's it for this week's video. Hope this has been helpful, and I look forward to seeing you next time.